Okay, the rain is gone, so now here's my T55 loosening up the upper caliper bolt. As you can see, now it's revealing it's a stainless steel bolt. And it's out. So I'm gonna put it on a pad here, so I don't use the pad so that I don't have to kneel on a loosening up the lower one. Once again, T55 clockwise, reverse to loosen the stuff. Okay, it's out. This is upper, this is lower. Okay, and now switching the socket to a to an 18 millimeter and lower bolt. This is to get the caliper bracket off. I'm going to take the rotor out as well, not just pads. If I was going to get just the pads off, the other bolts, these would be sufficient. This is lower, and for this one I need extension. Some people might argue that you don't. I find it easier with. And here we go. It's the rain has stopped. Nice and humid. It's also about 100 degrees outside. Perfect weather to work on a truck. Okay, the rest I should be able to get by hand. Okay, that's the upper one here. And now should be able to loosen up this whole thing. Here we go. Gonna pause it, so basically it should come off now. It's all loosened. I'm gonna, once I take it off, I'll continue with the video. Okay, using my breaker bar, I was able to separate the caliper from the caliper holder. Well, it's still on a rotor. As you can see now, I can just put the caliper away. As you can see, it's a double piston caliper. And here is my holder with the old brake pads. Like I said, they don't look too bad, but they were making noise. So, I don't know. 5 years. No, the truck is 8 years old. Original brakes. I don't know. They must go. Here's the rotor. Next thing we're gonna do, since I'm taking off the rotor, here are the little tabs. They're just like little washers out of sheet metal. I'm gonna use my pliers. And just kind of try to get it underneath. It's hard to do holding a phone with one hand and working on it with the other, but you get the idea. The idea is to try to get underneath of it and basically take it off. That's the only thing that's holding this this rotor in place, and this guy and this guy right here, and they should come off fairly easily once you get a grip. So that's what I'm gonna work on next. Back, I found it that it's easier if you use a flat screwdriver, just to on the other wheel that I've done before, I was able to grip it, but now to kind of just pry it underneath, just to get you started, flat screwdriver does the trick. And now I'll be able to grip it with a needle nose pliers and pull it off. Okay, yeah, as you can see, grab it with a nose pliers and pull it off. Not just kind of try to do it from one side to the other, kind of work yourself out so that you don't break this little tab. Okay, the tabs are off. Now I can get my rotor off. There we go. So I'm inspecting the rotor to see if this rotor I can work with it, or if I need to replace it. To replace these rotors, it's not too bad. In a local store, they go for about $40 a pop. To cut them, it's about $25 a piece. So I don't know, do the math, whatever, it's up to you whether you want to replace them. I'm not a mechanic, but looking at this thing, I think I can give it a try and see if I can get some extra mileage out of them, since they don't have any grooves, they're pretty smooth. I will however dress them. So next step will show how I'm prepping up the rotor to be reused with a brand new set of pads. I am gonna prep this rotor to work with a brand new set of pads. I'm just gonna gently knock off all the loose pieces with a hammer. I'm talking about gently, basically to get loose pieces of corroded steel off of it. I'm gonna do it on the inside and outside. Like I said, this is what I do. Someone might tell you not to do this. I'm not banging hard on it. I'm banging maybe with a 3-4 pounds of pressure just to loosen up the rusted steel. So I'm gonna do it on both sides, all around, on the inner and outer, just to loosen up corroded steel. Okay, I'm done with that. Now, as you can see, I have a rotor. It has this section here and this section here where pad was not touching. I will try to dress it up. Basically, I'm gonna use a palm sander with a 30 grit paper and smooth it all out so it's as smooth as possible. This is borderline. This side of a rotor is borderline. If it was the same way on both sides, I would discard the rotor. But I'm gonna see if I can make this one work. If not, then then it's gonna cost me another set of pads and a rotor. But to me, I'll give it a try. The other side of the rotor looks pretty good. It has a tiny groove up here, but I think that is what was making the sound. That was the little piece of metal that was rubbing, put a groove in it. It's not deep enough or wide enough to make it unusable. But like I said, it's just me being, I guess, frugal, trying to save $30 on a new rotor, or $40 for the rotor. So this one is borderline. I'll give it a try. But next, I will take the palm sander and try to dress it up. Okay, so here is I gave it a quick sand before, but I will demonstrate how I use it. I use a palm sander with a this, I believe it's a 36 grit paper. It's not a very high quality paper, but that's what I have laying around. The coarser the paper, the lower, obviously, the lower the number, the better it is for this process if you choose to do it this way. Here it goes. continue the same way on the other side, on this side, just to get the general idea. I'm just gonna continue that for another few minutes. It's difficult to do it holding the phone with one hand and palm sanding with the other, but you get the general idea. I'm gonna work on this side. I almost got it down to be fairly smooth. I'm gonna try to get it as smooth as possible, but I'm not gonna kill myself. The pads should do the job, but yeah, it's not very bad. It looks a lot worse than it is. The bump up here and here versus the smooth surface is not maybe 2-3 thousandths of an inch. So, like I said, it's worth taking a risk on my part. So one supply that I mentioned was the brake cleaner. You're probably gonna need it just to get all the grease that you have on your hands off of the parts. So what I did was I mounted the rotor reverse side out, so to make it easier. So this would be the internal part, and as you can see, if I adjust the white balance, I started scoring it. So basically what I do, I turn my rotary tool on and I make circular motion and slightly, I'm talking about, this is a surface scar. I'm just scoring the rotor all around so that it just, so that it has some type of a pattern other than a you know, circular. So I decided to go in a kind of a figure eight and just a circular motion going across. I don't know if you can see it well here, but that's what I'm doing. That's my way of dressing up the rotor, and I will do it the same way on the other side. So basically I have my Dremel tool on and I kind of go like this all around. And difficult to do with holding the phone, but that's, you get the general idea. And I have the circular motion in one hand and I spin the rotor with the other to kind of simulate what the professionals do on a lathe. But that's what I do. Like I said, if you buy a brand new rotor or you have it professionally cut, you don't have to do any of this. It will be done for you. Probably a lot better, but that's what I do. I will continue with the other side, and we'll get back to the rest of we're actually going to be working on compressing the cylinder and then cleaning up the rotor holder that's sitting right there on the side.